Friends, we're now in the primary closet. And as you can see, can you see a little bit of it? This part for me is actually a little bit overwhelming. And we've got to take a little bit of time as we go through this closet because we just want to make sure we don't leave out any important papers. Because my mom did leave important papers here, jewelry, and then maybe sometimes she puts her winnings somewhere in between somewhere. That's what she told us and we're trying to find it. Okay, so anyway, if you're downsizing a home or you just wanna declutter so that you have more breathing space, the best thing to do is to take one section at a time. So you saw that we did the bedroom, we did the bathroom, the linen closet, and now we're here in this closet. So how do you eat an elephant? One bite at a time. How do you declutter a whole house to put it on the market, or you just wanna get rid of stuff? It's one section at a time. So even for this closet, this is what we're gonna do. We're just gonna go, this is one section, and this part of the closet is another section. And usually I go from left to right, but this time we're gonna go right to left because this is where we're entering, and we're gonna go top to bottom. Although we really don't like to eat elephants, but you know what I mean. Okay, so here is the other side of the closet. So now you understand why I'm breaking this down into two sections. You can even do it into three sections, whatever works for you. And then you can see the height here. It's an amazing closet. And when sometimes something is this huge and amazing, you want to fill it up. But now we are going to unfill it. Okay guys, guess what my daughter just found? An elephant. Okay, I know this is funny. This is sentimental, you put toothpicks in here. Elephant is so strong that he can carry the toothpicks, but my parents have had this forever. Okay, bye elephant. Okay, so we have a system here. My daughter's here and my husband. So my daughter's pretty much holding the trash and she's gonna throw stuff into the trash and we're handing it to my husband to put it either in the Goodwill pile, the bulk trash pile, or the chemicals pile, or to bring home. We have dug up treasure. My husband was like, we're going back to the future. I think, no, that's totally Goodwill. Someone's gonna oh, that one. The hangers are trash, but what do you think? Goodwill? Will someone want this? I think I'll put it in Goodwill. Oh, oh wow. Okay, here's some papers. So you see that it gets overwhelming sometimes. Recycling, trash. Oh my gosh. Oh guys, the Beanie Babies. So any paperwork, we're just gonna keep and bring it to the storage unit and I'll deal with it later. Because if I deal with it now, it's gonna add another hour or so. Okay, so you can see we went through a ton of shoes. Basically half are Goodwill, half are trash because they're just not good enough to probably sell at Goodwill. geographic. Wow. 1974. Man. I don't know. I think what I'll do with the National Geographic is put them in the storage unit and find out online if they're worth anything. Because that's kind of worth my time. Listen, if it's not worth your time, then don't do it. Either bring it to the Goodwill or recycle. This is heavy. This is National Geographic 1976 to 86. I can't pull it. All right. Now we're going to come up here. Okay, so I think what I found in here are minted quarters, or I'm not really sure what that means, but we're keeping it. Certificate of authenticity, then it's just like coins. Okay, so keeping these, because like I said in my last video with the, or the other video with the linen closet, my mom said that there's stuff in the closet. This might be it, what she's talking about. Yeah, and there's a whole another box more. So I'll take time to go through this and see how much everything is worth. So hopefully that's the jackpot we're looking for. Okay, so my husband's gonna go up there to get the last final bits. Yes, good job. Tell us if it's heavy. No? Oh, okay.
It's all
boxed. Oh, they're just empty boxes. Let's see, boing, boing, boing.
I thought you were tricking.
Oh yeah, wait. Well, I didn't say, don't throw it yet. We gotta put it down here and check. Just, let's just make sure there's no sound of $100 bills in there. Oh, I remember that box. Cute, cute. Nothing? Nothing. Okay, so when he's bringing it down, my daughter's checking. Whoa, that is high up there. Make sure there's nothing way back there in the corner. Maybe some casino chips to cash in. Whoa. Okay, is there any shelf liner?
Yeah.
Yeah, take those down.
You want this down?
Yeah, that one down too. Whoa, okay, look at that. Is there a shelf liner over there?
No.
All right, the last shelf liner, and he got a couple things from the second section. Okay, so this twin mattress is since we were kids, and so we're gonna bring that to the side of the house for the junk removal that we'll have come later. All right, let's see what's in this trash bag that was up on the top shelf. Oh, look at this. This is cute. The Christmas tree. Isn't that cute? These are those hangers that you could hang multiple hangers on it. Okay, Goodwill. This is trash, that's Goodwill. All right, we got these three bags. Whoa, okay. No, it's not bags, it's more magazines. Oh, travel and leisure. My mom loves to travel. Okay, well, let's just assume there's no cash in here. I just kind of want to make sure. There's no important papers at the bottom. Oh my goodness, what are these magazines? Scientific American. This I might keep. Not for me, but anyone wants it on Goodwill. Charles Dickens. Oh, El Philly. Oh, the Smithsonian. Oh my gosh. I think what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna look up Scientific American and Smithsonian Institute. Unless by the end of this video, I change my mind. So heavy. I'm like, do I really want to bring this to the storage unit or deal with it? Okay, we've been an hour in this part of the closet. Now, why some things take longer than others, I really don't know. But let me just check inside these luggages. Okay, I'm just going to check inside, make sure there's nothing in it. They're cloths, so we're just going to throw them. I don't think you'd want this at Goodwill. Whoa. This could be Goodwill, yeah? I'm not sure why I thought it would be empty. At least there's not papers in them. Okay, I guess that would. Oh, that it's a tag. I thought it's a tag. It's a luggage tag. Okay, trash. Papers here, drawing for the house in the backyard. That definitely had a green thumb. Yeah, so obviously, I won't keep those. If you find things like this that are good enough to frame, those would be great pictures for your house. But I'm not into that. I mean, I would be, but I think that would make me actually a little bit too sentimental. So, yeah. Okay, I'm just checking if there's anything in the back there. So what we would probably do is when the junk removal people come, I'll have them bring this. Because what they do is there's things that are obvious trash, and then there's things that they could try to donate. All right. Oh, thank goodness. Either my brother or my husband took care of this the other time. So, thank you so much. I tell you, paper is my nemesis. So I'm so glad I want to deal with this filing cabinet, at least here. Okay, you can see that it's all done here in section one of the primary closet. So this is the first section of the closet that we're taking care of. I was thinking about having a second section, but now that I look at it, I'm thinking we're just going to do it three sections for the closet. So there'll be three parts to the closet, or else this video will get way too long. The other thing I see is that it took us about an hour and 10 minutes, which doesn't seem like a lot, but when you're 2.5 hours into decluttering, that's already tiring. You're making so many decisions. Decision, whether it's trash, donate, keep, or think about, it's still a lot of decisions coming one after another. So this is a time where you may want to take a break. For me, I found that 4 hour stretches are pretty much the max. The only reason we probably gonna stop here is because we gotta get back to the house, our internet's not working, and the technician can only come in a certain time. So that's where we're going. So, but anyway, click the next playlist to see more of the videos of us decluttering and downsizing from this home, just so you can have motivation and know that there's other people who may be in a similar situation that is, you might be having decision fatigue, or you might be really motivated, or this can give you that extra push to start on it today. So whether you're downsizing or not, maybe you just want to declutter to just have a more serene and quiet space, then this is the playlist for you.